Hi, my name is Jared Broad, and in this bootcamp, we're going to be doing momentum-based tactical allocation. This involves moving your portfolio buying power between different assets depending on market conditions. We're going to be exploring using an indicator, how to warm that indicator up, and then finally how to use set holdings to perform our actual trading. So let's get started by clicking on the first task, which is focused around setting up the strategy. So first we need to add data for SPY at daily resolution, add bond data at daily resolution, and then set our starting cash. So the assets here, SPY, is representative of the S&P 500. BND is a bond market ETF. So this is classified as the safe option, and the S&P 500 is classified as the risky option. So let's ask for the data we need. And then finally, it's saying to set our starting cash. Okay, let's see how it goes. So having a risk asset class and a safe asset class is one characteristic of some momentum-based tactical allocation strategies. And there we go, we'll pass the first task. On to the next one. So in this task, we're going to be using an indicator for the first time. In QuantConnect, we have a number of capitalized methods like this, MOMP, which stands for Momentum Percent Indicator. But when you use the capitalized methods, it acts as a shortcut which automatically adds the data at the resolution that you need. So here, it's in the example on the side, you can see that it's asking for IBM with 30-minute bars, with the resolution and the period here. So this is a very common pattern. All of the indicators follow this pattern of ticker, period, and resolution. Underneath, this is driven by the momentum percent class. This full class name is still accessible in your algorithm if you need it, but it isn't automatically updated with data. So most of the time, you just want to use the shortcut helper methods. So the task objectives for this one is to say add a 50-day momentum percent indicator for SPY. So we can do that using the MOMP, M-O-M-P. SPY, and then how many periods, and then what resolution. And we want to do the same for bond. Okay, so you can see here that we've used the helper to automatically save an self-updating indicator to this class property SPY momentum. And that's all it's needing us to do, so let's submit that and see how we go. Okay, great, we've passed that task and on to the next one. Okay, so when you add an indicator, it's not quite ready as soon as you add it. So for example, in this one, we have SPY and bond, which are a 50-day momentum indicator. So when you first launch this backtest or when you first deploy it to live trading, it won't necessarily be ready until 50 days later, which is too long for us to wait in reality. So we can use the warm-up feature in QuantConnect, which automatically pumps the data through the algorithm before it starts. So to do that, you can use set warm-up, which is located in QC algorithm. And we want to warm it up with 50 days. Now that we've got our algorithm warming up, let's use the set benchmark method to set a benchmark for the strategy. See here, it's just set benchmark, and then the asset you'd like to use as the benchmark. Let's use SPY as our benchmark. And we've set the benchmark and we've asked for the warm-up of 50 days. Now we're ready to go. One important thing here to mention here that isn't actually asked of us in the objectives is you can see here that we're saying if the bond momentum indicator is not ready, then return from on data. Because indicators might take some time to warm up, you want to always check if they're ready to use before you use them. And you can do that with this isReady property. Let's see how it goes. Okay, great. On to the next task. Now we finally get to use our indicators. So we can see here the objective says that if the SPY has more upward momentum than bond, then liquidate our holdings in bond and allocate 100% to SPY. One important but subtle thing to note here is that it says liquidate our holdings in bond and then allocate 100% to SPY. Remember to always downsize your position before increasing it with other assets. So to access an indicator's value, you can use the indicator.current.value property. So if our SPY momentum value is greater than our bond upward momentum, so you see here we can use the self.liquidate helper that we mentioned in earlier lessons, and then just pass in BND to liquidate all holdings in BND. If we don't have any holdings, it won't matter, it'll just move on. And then after that, we want to allocate 100% of our portfolio to SPY. So to do this, we can use the SetHoldings helper. Pass in SPY. And then just simply pass in 1, which indicates that you allocate 100% of our portfolio. Otherwise, we want to do the opposite if this condition isn't met, which means we liquidate SPY and we allocate 100% of our portfolio to BND. So if you translate this to English, you're basically saying that if the stock market in general has more momentum than bonds and is trending in a stronger fashion, then move all of our cash into that asset. And then if the bond market is trending better than the S&P 500, then move everything back into bonds. Okay, those are the only objectives. Let's see how we go. Tactical allocation is a very common quant strategy. And oftentimes people move allocations between different asset types, such as real estate or bonds or the broader market index or the international indexes. And awesome, there we go, the task is complete. Okay, with this task, we're looking to time the rebalancing to make sure that it doesn't happen every single day. So if you notice here, this indicator check and then the subsequent trading happens on every single data point that comes through. If you're trading with a large portfolio, this rebalancing can be very expensive. So a lot of the time, rebalancing is done on a specific frequency. So we want to use this self.time property to make sure that we're only rebalancing every Wednesday. So let's copy this helper and put it here. And then when a specific condition is hit, we want to make sure we return. And so that we don't do any trading unless it's a specific time. One thing to note is that we're using daily data. So this means that when a data point comes through, it was actually from the previous day. A day is marked as complete when it is fully completed and the next day is started. So in this case, we want to say if it's not Tuesday. So by the time Tuesday ends, Wednesday starts, and then we can place our trades. So we also are using not here because we only want to trade on the Wednesdays. So let's submit this and see how it goes. Okay, great. Congratulations. You've just passed the Momentum-Based Tactical Allocation Bootcamp, where we've learned about indicators, how to warm up your algorithm, we're using time, and we're scheduling our rebalancing to make sure it doesn't happen too often. I look forward to seeing you in the next lesson.